In this problem, we're given a combination of two blocks. We have a 1.9 kilogram block on the top, 4.2 kilograms on the bottom. These blocks are tied together with a string that has a tension of T2 in it. And then we use a second string with a tension of T1 to pull the combination upward with a given acceleration of 3.2 meters per second squared. And of course, the question is, what are the tensions T1 and T2 in those two strings? So like any dynamics problem, we begin by putting forces into the diagram on every piece of the problem. So starting from the bottom here, we're showing the weight of M2, that's the force of gravity pulling down on M2, and that's going to be given by M2 times G, where G is the magnitude of the acceleration of gravity. Now the string between the two blocks, remember that had a tension of T2, but strings pull at both ends. So that string is pulling upward on M2 with a tension of T2, but also downward on M1 with a tension of T2. There's a second force downward on M1, and that's the weight of M1, so that's given by M1G. And then finally, T1 is the tension of that upper string pulling upward on M1. And so the next step in solving our dynamics problem is to apply Newton's second law to each moving piece in the system. So we'll start with the analysis on M1. And as a quick reminder here, Newton's second law says that F net is equal to MA. So we're going to write down the net force on this particular mass and then set it equal to M1A. Using a standard coordinate system where upward is positive, T1 will count as positive. And then we have T2 pulling down on M1, so we have minus T2. But we also have gravity pulling down on M1 with a magnitude of M1G. So there's the net force on M1, and that must be equal to the size of M1, so there's M1, times the acceleration of that mass. Now we do a similar thing for M2. Again, there's a reminder that we're applying Newton's second law to M2, so F net equals MA. T2 is the only upward force here on M2. And M2G is the only downward force. So there's the net force on M2, and that has to be equal to M2 times A. So what we've built here is a system of two equations and two unknowns, where the unknowns are the two tensions, but everything else has been given to us. And this system is really nicely set up to use elimination. If I add the two equations, so I add the left sides and the right sides, the T2s are going to cancel out, and we should be able to solve for T1. So doing this addition on the left-hand side, I end up with a T1. The T2s are gone, and I have a minus M1G. And then from the second equation, I have minus M2G. And then on the right-hand side, I have M1A plus M2A. Now adding M1G and M2G to both sides and factoring as we go, I end up with G times M1 plus M2 on the right-hand side. And then with a similar factorization, A times M1 plus M2. Well, now M1 plus M2 becomes a common factor, and I can write this as M1 plus M2 multiplying G plus A. So that's the general solution to the problem, and now we can sub in our numbers to get the actual numerical value of T1. So we get that T1 is going to be 1.9 kilograms plus 4.2 kilograms multiplying 9.8 meters per second squared plus 3.2 meters per second squared. And when we run the numbers on this to three significant digits, we get 79.3 newtons. So now we want to solve for T2, and it looks like the easiest way to do that is to look at our second equation. So if we take that second equation and just add M2G to both sides, we're going to find that T2 is M2G plus M2A. We can factor the M2 out of this, and we get M2 times the quantity G plus A. And we're ready to sub in some numbers here. So we get 4.2 kilograms multiplying the quantity 9.8 meters per second squared plus 3.2 meters per second squared. And when we run the numbers on this one to three significant digits, we get 54.6 newtons. So we solved the problem, but I want to show one way that we could check our work. So there's our two tensions in the diagram now. We have 79.3 for T1 and 54.6 newtons for T2. And one way to check our work here is to just analyze the net force on one of these masses. I'm going to choose M1, and then figure out what the acceleration is and make sure it turns out to be 3.2. So in that force analysis, I get 79.3 newtons pulling up. We have T2 pulling down, so negative 54.6 newtons. And then we have M1G pulling down, so the force of gravity on M1. All right, all of that is equal to M1A, so that's 1.9 kilograms times A. And we're just going to check that A comes out to the right number. It should be 3.2 meters per second squared. And when I combine all the forces on the left, I get 6.08 newtons. And then on the right, we have 1.9 kilograms times our acceleration. And when we solve for A here, we get the same 3.2 meters per second squared. So we're confident we've done everything right in our problem. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.